Hello, my name is Aaron, and I am currently in the 7th grade at my middle school. In social studies class, we're doing a 20% project, and the main theme for that project is to make the world a better place. My decision for the project is to make a good news day, where for one day, the amount of bad news is lessened and good news increased. I tried to do this because the amount of bad news that we see in the media, television, anything, is mostly bad news, whether it be terrorism, politics, or world affairs, you name it, there's always going to be something sad. So I have decided to flip the tables on the media and create a better society where we can all come together and enjoy watching the news, because there's going to be more happy stuff on it. So I've decided to make my very own Good News Day. And with our first headlines, they're going to be funny articles to just make you smile, laugh, whatever makes you feel good. Now, our first news story for the funny category is quite unexpected yet completely hilarious at the same time. The first car to ever be caught speeding is now going up for display at Hampton Palace Court in the United Kingdom. What you are about to see now is the car caught in the act itself. What you're currently seeing is an 1896 Arnold Benz motor carriage, and is widely believed to be the very first car ticketed for speeding. Now, back in the 19th century, speed limits were very low. The maximum you could go was a whopping 2 miles per hour. Then one day, a man came waltzing into town named Walter Arnold, and it's not known if he knew the rules around town, but being the complete savage he was, he decided to go a whopping 8 miles an hour. Arnold was eventually caught on police bicycle pursuit, which is completely hilarious. I bet it would be very fun to see. And he was fined 1 shilling for the act. Now, if you don't know what 1 shilling is equivalent to, 1 shilling is equivalent to about 16 cents in America. Our next story is about the actor Hugh Jackman, who you may know as the Wolverine from the X-Men series. Hugh Jackman has played the Wolverine in over 9 movies, so you'd probably guess he'd put lots of research and get lots of information on the Wolverine to, you know, really be the character, really kind of get into the act, you know? Well, apparently not. Hugh Jackman had no idea what a Wolverine was until shooting 2000's X-Men. When filming for the flick began, director Bryan Singer noticed something was off about Jackman's performance. Jackman recalled the incident as happening like this. Singer told Jackman, "Are you sort of walking funny? What's wrong?" Then Jackman told Singer he'd been doing this thing with wolves. Jackson was then told to replicate a Wolverine. Jackman then replied with, "Well, there's no such thing as a Wolverine." With director Singer sarcastically replying, "Dude, go to a zoo." Now, have you ever seen something in your toilet that you weren't planning on seeing? Maybe somebody didn't flush or you dropped your phone in there. Well, a woman in Florida discovered an unwanted guest after she lifted the lid. To her surprise, there was a foot-long iguana basking in the water in her toilet. The Florida woman came home from a long, hard day at work, planning to just relax, when she found a 12-inch iguana. Scared, she called 2 family members to come and take care of the situation. One of the 2 family members she called happened to be her grandson, Gabriel, who then checked in on the iguana, just chilling out in the toilet. He then later decided to call 911 because it was much bigger than he expected and he didn't want to get bitten or scratched by it. The young iguana was then boxed up by Miami-Dade Fire Rescue's Venom 1 unit, who say this is definitely a first for them. The most likely reason the iguana was able to get into their toilet was because it crawled up through the pipes. And getting there was not that hard as you think. There was a nearby canal that had sewage pipes leading to it, and so it most likely just crawled up through there and made its way to the home. Seth MacFarlane, creator of Family Guy, American Dad, and several more, has a new comedy show coming to Fox. The new show coming to Fox is called The Orville and is a Star Trek parody created by Seth MacFarlane and directed by Jon Favreau, who you may know as the director of Iron Man and the 2016 Jungle Book remake. With cast members like MacFarlane, Norm MacDonald of SNL, Halton Sage from Goosebumps and Neighbors, and Adrian Palicki from Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., you know this has got to be one good show. Here's a short clip of the new Orville trailer.
Ed, have a seat. I have good news. There's a ship available, the USS Orville.
Ever since I was a kid, I have wanted to serve on an exploratory vessel.
You're nobody's first choice for this job, but we have 3,000 ships to staff, and we need captains.
Can I have one of these mints?
Those are marbles. We're giving you one last chance.
I just want to say I am thrilled to be your new captain. I want this to be an efficient ship, but also one that you're glad to be serving on. Lieutenant Commander Bordas, your entire species is male, isn't it?
That is correct, sir.
Probably not a lot of arguments about leaving the toilet seat up and that kind of thing, right?
Mocklins urinate only once per year.
Really? That's, I mean, I'm up 2-3 times a night.
That is unfortunate.
It is.
For our next story, Russell Wilson of the Seattle Seahawks posted a video to Twitter on May 20th of what appeared to be him at his son's birthday party. The video shows his son inside a motorcycle made of balloons racing with another boy. To make it even cuter, he's making vroom noises as he goes. Check this out.
And he's driving a motorcycle.
Go down there with Christian, okay? On your mark, come this way. Get set, and go!
Go, 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 go!
Trust me, there's just no way you can't smile at that. Now, we all know Sheldon Cooper from The Big Bang Theory. He's smart, geeky, and very socially awkward. But have you ever wondered what life was like for him as a kid? Well, there's a movie coming to CBS called Young Sheldon, showing his family, his interests, and his school days. This interesting flick will be a special one-time event, airing September 25th, 8:30 or 7:30, depending on where you live in the country. Here's a segment of what the trailer looks like.
You understand that some people are going to be intimidated by you because of how smart you are?
Or maybe they'll recognize my intellect and make me their leader.
Lord, look after my son. Don't let him get stuffed in a gym bag.
Oh, dear.
You doing okay?
I guess. Hey, Mom, look, that girl's pregnant.
Congratulations.
All right, everybody. I'm sure you're all aware we have a student with us who is remarkably gifted. Yes, Sheldon?
This boy's hair is too long. This boy is wearing sports attire outside of a designated area, and this girl's blouse is diaphanous, which means I can see her brassiere. Also, in violation of the grooming code, you have a bit of a mustache.
For our last funny story, we have Johnny Depp surprising fans at the Disneyland ride Pirates of the Caribbean. Johnny Depp, who you may know as Captain Jack Sparrow, appeared dressed in full costume at the ride Pirates of the Caribbean, which shares the same name as the movie series. It was a totally unexpected shock to fans to see Depp greeting them for only a few moments at the ride. Depp was at the ride promoting the next Pirates of the Caribbean movie, Dead Man Tell No Tales.
I've been expecting you for hours.
Oh my God, oh my God.
My name is Captain Jack Sparrow. Hello, and I would like to swim to you, jump in your boat.
What a ride!
Ah! Ah! Oh! Who wants rum? So do I. Bring it. Does the sword make my bum look big?
Yes.
Naughty.
Now it's time for our more serious stories. We've all seen GoPros before, right? They can capture amazing things such as hang gliding, surfing, and free running. But in this case, this GoPro literally saved this man's life. Aman Al-Waley is a reporter who works for The Sun who was caught in the middle of a sniper fight. Al-Waley was filming from the front lines of Mosul when the GoPro perched on his neck seemed to suddenly explode. It turned out that the reason for the GoPro's sudden combustion was that a sniper bullet had hit it. If that GoPro was just the slightest bit off or wasn't there at all, Al-Waley might not have survived. Amar was then given medical treatment at the scene and later treated for dehydration. Surprisingly, he was not hurt from the bullet. Journalist Owen Holdaway was right next to Al-Waley when he was shot. He ended up catching it all on video, but sadly due to copyright, I cannot show the clip. But it is available in the description of the video. Our next story is a remarkable and beautiful one, which means that endangered animals are getting more attention through the magic of professional wildlife photography. Some of the world's most endangered animals are having records made of them by SONI, the European Outdoor Conservation Association, and some top wildlife photographers such as Sam Hobson. The project, created by SONI, is meant to raise awareness for the beautiful endangered species. The photographers were equipped with an RX10-3 for the pictures, which has a super telephoto lens and a silent shutter to ensure that the animals weren't disturbed. The images are absolutely stunning and show the true beauty of nature. Now that we're done with the serious stories, it's time for our music category. And what better way to add a smile to someone's face with some great tunes? Last month, the a cappella group Pentatonix came out with a cover of Queen's Bohemian Rhapsody, and to say it's beautiful would be an understatement. The amazing harmony and vocals will give you chills. Check this out.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see. Ooh.
I'm just a poor boy, I need no sympathy.
'Cause I'm easy come, easy go, little high, little low.
Any way the wind blows doesn't really matter to me.
Our next song is by an artist that you probably haven't heard the name of in several years. Psy, yes, Gangnam Style Psy, has dropped a new album with one of the songs on the album titled New Face. The New Face music video has received 32.5 million views on YouTube in just 15 days. The music video features Psy in various costumes, South Korean idol and actress Sun Na-yoon, and a whole lot of dabbing. You're bound to smile while watching this creative video. Well, thank you for viewing my first Good News Day upload. Make sure to share this with friends and family members to add more joy to their everyday life. This is Aaron signing off, but remember, stay cool, stay fun, and keep being kind. I need some